What's going on, y'all, man? We back at it again. It's your boy Bezo with Wills. Y'all make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe, and let's get straight to it. Y'all see it in the title. Body work. We got a little bit of body work today. I got a hood dropped off. I thought it was in perfect condition, but it ain't. I thought it was going to be a straight shoot. Easy video. Easy day. But no. Let's take a look at this. The old me would have been like, not very good at body work. He didn't say anything about body work, so I ain't doing it. But I'm getting a little better with my quality. I got a lot more clientele. So I want to kind of, one, this is practice. And two, I just want to see if I can master it, man. This is the perfect opportunity. Like I said, he didn't say anything about the dents. He doesn't know anything. I'm not even going to tell him. I'm going to just try and make it. I'm going to try and fix it. So right here, we got a deep scratch right there. Like I said, the old me would have been like, I feel that bad boy with primer. This is Will. But yeah, man, we're gonna sand these down with some 320. If, like I said, I'm not a professional body tech or anything like that, so this is just how I've been getting by lately. Until I get some comments every now and then from the vets and stuff like that that'll kind of pitch in advice, and I love it. I definitely need your advice. Even drop a comment on this video as well. Feel free to do that. Because like I said, I went to school for this 5 years ago, but I don't remember hardly anything, man. So, man, we getting ready to sand it down with some 320. Overall, if this hood did not have any body damage, I would have scuffed it with the Scotch-Brite and then shot it and then painted it. Literally, you don't need no primer, none of that. So let's try and get it smoothed down. Clearly is not gone, and that's as much as I want to go down. So we're gonna have to just put a little glaze over it. Little glaze, you got Bondo, you got tiger hair, you got fiberglass, you got glaze. It's not even a dent, so we're gonna glaze that bad boy up. We got these three dents as well. You want to just sand them down with some 320, like I said, just get it smooth. You want that Bondo to stick onto something, whatever you use in fiberglass, Bondo, glaze, you want it to stick to the bare metal. Man, I got the dents sanded down. These are the areas we will be applying the filler, the body filler, whatever you want to call it, Bondo, glaze, whatever you want to call it. Anyways, I kind of peeped up on some new information when I was actually picking up some paint, because I was asking, I was like, why do I keep leaving the rings around it? Please let me know. Like once I glaze it, sand it down, I feel like it's perfect. I feel like damn near perfect. And I'll prime it, I'll look at it at an angle, I'm like, I don't see nothing, I'll paint it. And I'll see these rings around it. Please leave it in the comments. I'm begging y'all, man. Like, I'm trying to perfect this. And I've YouTubed it. I couldn't find like the direct answer. I've talked to some cats, but somebody was like, yo, make it wider, make it blend more. As in, if the dent is right here, I need to come out here with it, basically. But I don't know how far. Is this far enough? Is this not enough? You know what I'm saying? So leave it in the comments, man. I'm learning with y'all. I want to learn with y'all at the same time. You know what I'm saying? I'm not about to sit here and say I'm a professional painter, professional body filler. None of that. Like, I'm literally learning this crap. So I think I'm going to bring it out a little bit more, as a matter of fact. Let's do it. I sand it a little bit more on the outside. Man, it is funny. Y'all probably watching this video like, damn, he about to fuck up. Oh, he should have went wider. Oh, I'm about to watch him mess up. I know, man. Y'all just leave it in the comments, man. Trial and error. Shout out to Ross, man. He came through. Man, I love it. Like, when you got, like, top dogs who actually genuinely want to show you how to, you know, how to do stuff or how to come up. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. So, appreciate him for that. I never even used that. I've been waiting for somebody's Rolls Royce to come in. No, I'm just playing. I've been waiting on somebody's car to come in to use that. But we're gonna take it slight. We don't need none of that. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and grab this gold. All right, man, it's the real deal. Put your gloves on, man. Gotta be official. This did not happen overnight. All the little, my little paint supplies and gloves that I got, and seem like I'm all professional. No, man,
No, this did not happen overnight. Sacrifice. Build my way up. I don't even need this much. Anyways, that's a different topic. You don't need a lot. You don't need a lot. I honestly, and that's why I wish I had a body tech here, because I don't know my ratios. I just kind of go with it. From what I remember, don't need a lot. That's probably enough. Too much hardener, it'll over harden and crack. That I do know. Not enough, it's gonna take forever to dry, and you might not dry it. It might not dry at all. Shit. But one thing I do remember in Votech from 2014 and 15 was not to stare it. Just like that, as you can see, just boom. You don't need any coordination to do that. Just kind of smash it down, get all the air bubbles and pockets. Cause I've probably had 90% of my body work do that.
I know I said glaze. I'm not even about to play like I didn't forget. I was supposed to glaze it instead of Bondo. So yeah, doesn't need a lot. And my teacher said, stop going over it. Just one swipe, that's it. Don't do what I did. I'm still learning the same as y'all, I guess. I'm gonna try and do less swipes. And the messier you are, the more work you create for yourself. So just, boom. Probably need to go a little wider, I guess. Don't go ahead. Y'all can critique me. Y'all can critique me. I know it's probably fine, but I want to play around with it and kind of see if I can just one time it, as in, fuck it. Should I have put them together? Should I have not put them together? I don't know.
All right, I'll leave it alone.
What we want, this you don't want, the lines you don't want, the thick, that's too thick, that's what you don't want. All these rivets and whatnot and jagged edges, these sharp lips, you don't want none of that. You just want to keep it one swipe, real smooth. That's gonna be an issue. It's probably already too dry, but I'm still trying to. That's why I want a body tech. You want to just leave it alone and keep it flat. Still hasn't dried on me, so still kind of playing around with it. But I wanted to see if I could just one time it, basically. Because my issue lately, I would have it. I lay a slap of Bondo on all the dents, and then I let it dry, come back to it, and I realize it's too low. So I had to go back, open my cans up, put on some gloves, and blah, 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 and then redo it. Putting more layers, obviously, when I just want to just do one thick ass coat and just have it done, just sand it down. And it's just like, but I know I got a lot to catch up on. I got a lot of work to do. Cause this is, I know in the body tech world, this is unacceptable, but we're going to see how, I mean, like I said, if it's your first time doing it, I don't expect you to be perfect. So, as a beginner, such as I, we're going to see what we can do with this. Let's figure out if Bondo has to be laid down with quality. Yeah, normally you want to block it down, find a block that's the appropriate size. But unfortunately, I don't have any. So, I will have to use the DA. But I got a little pad on it. Normally, I would use a a block. But let's see if we can get away with this. So my phone getting ready to die. that sucks. Anyways, man, you just want to close your eyes, and the moment you feel like any type of waviness, this is a low spot. It's a low spot right here, and that's the thing. Okay, so I feel a low spot, so I'm gonna go back over it. And then this is like, this is good. I don't need to even go over this. See, that's straight smooth. gone. We ain't worried about that. Now we got one this problem. So I'm gonna try and perfect this as much as I can while my phone is sitting on the charger. I'm gonna bring that bad boy back and show y'all. So y'all stay tuned. So I scuffed it down with some 120, sanded that Bondo down, got it as smooth as I could get it, hit it with the primer. So we're gonna let it sit, let it do its thing, let it cure, and then hold on, let's see. Yep, some damn rings. We're just gonna probably hit it with a couple more coats of primer, and we're gonna see where we're gonna go from there. All right, man, don't panic. I ain't gonna leave y'all. All right, so pretty much the process was put some primer, self-etching primer right here out of the can. I'm not about to load my paint gun up, you know what I mean, for them little spots. I did like four pretty thick coats and let it sit. Let it dry, let it do its thing. About 15, 20 minutes later, I went over it with 320. I went 320. Now, I don't know if you're supposed to go with 320, but we gonna figure it out. We gonna find out if that was a good idea or not. So, I went with 320, 400 to 600 to Scotch-Brite. Scotch-Brite the whole thing. And like I said, y'all saw it. It was three big dents. Well, three decent dents and a deep scratch right there. So, I don't see anything and I don't feel anything. I close my eyes. It looks good, smells good, tastes good. No, I'm just fucking, I'm just playing around. Hold on, let me see. I don't see anything. I mean, I don't see, man, it's a little nick right there. Y'all see, oh, it's gone. Okay, fuck it. Anyway, and then the same thing right here. I don't see no rings. I don't see any of that. Yeah, like I said, I don't see no evidence of bodywork, so I'm anxious. I'm scared. I will probably throw about 10 more coats of primer. Y'all, man, this is a learning process. Got my police flag, like, damn, it look good though. Just gotta inspect. It's a thing you wanna do, man, cause you don't want no rework. Yeah, everything else check. That's a gorgeous color though. That shit clean. I didn't even know it was metallic on it. I ain't gonna lie, should've did a drop coat. But now overall, man, that thing laid down. I was a little skeptical about the hood. And, let me see. All right. I don't see no rings or nothing like that. But yeah, man, y'all stay tuned for this clear coat. I know that clear coat gonna bust, man. This was $106 a quart. Like, damn. One of them is $106, and this one right here, $22. $106. That's crazy, yo. We'll be right back.
All right. Your bad boy is finished. We are clear. Two coats of clear is on there. Lay down pretty smooth. Could be better because I know I've seen showroom quality paint. So I got to critique myself if I want to be able to lay that down. So I know it's going to be some things that I might point out that you guys probably be like, what the hell is he talking about? The damn thing's great. But I've had that eye before. No offense. But when you have that painter's eye, it's like, it's crazy, man. It's like, critique yourself about every little, the slightest little hair, dust, debris. Yeah, but I know the circumstances of, you know, me having that. I don't have a paint booth. I don't have a base coat gun, a clear coat gun, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, so it's a lot of factors. But overall, man, I can't beat myself up. Wet sand and buff, this actually is a clear coat that does require it to be wet sand and buffed. Pro Clear is not your high dollar clear. So yeah, overall this thing did lay down pretty smooth to me. So yeah, little orange peel, that's really it though. I didn't have no trash, no pigment snags or anything like that. So bumper came out fairly good. I know I'm gonna do the basic two coats for like just regular factory, like if it ain't no custom work or nothing like that. So, but overall, man, I still wanna be able to figure out the orange peel situation. The thing is, I don't even know if this is as good as it's gonna be, you know, cause I don't know the full potential of that clear coat. So I know this a higher end clear coat up here that I didn't use. And I ain't even gonna say higher, it's probably, I think it was like $65. I think it was like 65 or something like that. That one was like 50. So other than that, man, y'all feel free to blow them comments up. What can I improve on? I wet my floor down every paint job, so have that fan with the fluid, with the air coming in, that fan with the air going out. These three fans, I know I kept those closed today. It was a small project, so got more content coming, better quality coming, better projects coming, man. So like I said, man, it's all a start, trying to work my way up to the top, and it definitely doesn't happen overnight. You gotta build your way up. LeBron James when he was a baby. So I mean, well, he kind of was because his name was LeBron. Well, anyway, y'all know, y'all get the point, man. Yeah, got some dust from the wind blowing in. Majority of that just blow it down. Y'all see it falling. Like, damn, that's crazy. But, yeah.